Oké, ben je ready? Action!
What time is it? It's like 9:30 p.m. We're shooting Zayden's music video. I think Faris and I are making a small little, just a tiny, teeny tiny cameo. Can't wait for you guys to see it. It's gonna be dope.
I'm right here at Zayden's music video shoot. I did some shots of me like riding on a tricycle or trishaw, is that what it's called? It was difficult, but I saw the shots and I think it's like, it's gonna be amazing. It's gonna gel all together, like all three videos. It's a storyline and I can't wait for y'all to see it. I'm excited. Peace.
Happy to be here. Can't wait for everybody to hear this, and you know, hope you all like this new version, new take of a very iconic song from Singapore.
Hello, my name is Moses and I'm the director for the shoot. Actually, this shoot came on as a surprise. Kind of like a surprise now, because I wasn't actually expecting this. Mode Entertainment actually approached me and asked me whether I would be interested to direct this music video.
I'm more involved in the pre-production stage.
I helped to write out the concept and basically Moses, who's the director, like his vision, so I helped to craft out the proposal.
It's a Singapore Tourism Board initiative together with Universal Music.
I mean, it was definitely a challenge because we had a limited time to prepare for the shoot. I think we only had like 1 week.
So we actually had to rush. I have night blindness. I couldn't say, sorry, who are you? Doesn't make sense for a producer to say that.
Keep the equipment in the dark, count the equipment. There's a lot of location, yeah, so we have to move fast.
From point A to point B.
So you have all these landmarks that you want to feature in this music video, but that is a challenge in itself because to actually film at the landmarks require a lot of permits.
There's a lot of back and forth between agencies and like public agencies to get those permits and location secured.
After agreeing to the music video production, I heard the first demo. Turns out to be a cover of Xu Meijing's 城里的月光. 城里的月光 is actually a theme song of a very popular series called what, 豆腐街. The concept is to remember the past, appreciate the present, and look forward to the future. There's the old Satay Club where it used to be, at where we filmed at the Esplanade Park.
I didn't realize that there was an old Malayan park or something like that, and versus where the new Malayan is, even though it's quite near to each other. So I thought that was quite interesting fun fact about the Malayan. It was like at, I think it was close to like 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. already. It was like one whole slew of police car and one like big SWAT truck. We got ambushed or something. Like
I was like, oh crap, did we do something wrong? Oh my god, they're gonna chase us away. We're not gonna finish this shoot.
Actually, they were just on their like usual rounds and we just showed them the permit.
And then throughout the music video, there is a visual effects, a representative of something to do with the future, the latest trend being seen in TikTok right now. Like the part where Zayden is doing his thing at the Helix Bridge and we added visual effects.
Film at Haw Par Villa at night. I think we were there like close to midnight or even like beyond midnight. And it was my first time going to Haw Par Villa in so many years. So going into Haw Par Villa when it's very empty and there's not like a living soul inside, only like ghosts.
The lantern part is really interesting. Okay, for the first try on the lantern, Luis burned the wax to make the lantern float. He actually managed to and went up high. The way how he controlled is like a kite, but then eventually the wax dropped. It's quite a big flame. He's safe, don't worry, nothing happened.
The way we did the sky lantern was actually all done in post lah, because there's lack of time and then a lot of hassle.
Compositing the fake stuff into an actual video to make it seem real.
For the post-production, right, to make the things a bit more realistic,
so I managed to capture some B-rolls of the full moon. So we managed to come it into the Haw Par Villa scene.
The Chinese looking attire was a representation of remembering the past. I was thinking maybe we could ask an Wusu troop. Then we found Vincent. Yeah, Vincent was pretty helpful in arranging his troop for us during the MV shoot.
I was asked to do up the projection content for the Zayden's reshoot at the warehouse, project some images of the Tembusu tree that we shot at Botanic Garden, more grunge kind of element, so we project on the Zayden.
Zayden? Zayden is surprisingly very easy to work with. He is spontaneous and he's willing to try. He will just wing it. And usually he will wing it quite successfully.
Okay, so we shoot this MV during the 7th month.
For Chinese, it's the Ghost Festival. So at the point of time where we were shooting on our first day,
initially there's light one. But once we reach right, for a while later,
everything black out. It's like
it only shut off at around our area and the area that we want to shoot. The rest of the park is littered.
Encountered one jogger, one female jogger jog past us and then stop and ask us, why is it so dark? Then I ask her, do you jog here often? Then she said, yeah. So it's not supposed to be this dark, right? Then she said, yeah, it's not supposed to be this dark.
Very hard to find our location. End up, we still miss the spot that we actually gonna shoot at.
Moses!
To wait,
you
never wait. Moses? Yeah. Moses! I'm not a very superstitious guy. It's a bit weird. It's like maybe just 5 minutes after I walk around and kind of like pray to the grounds that please let us have a successful shoot. And after 5 minutes later, the lights turn on, which nobody know why was the light off. It's like something or somewhere don't want us to shoot there. Quite an interesting episode for me personally.
And we did all the things that you shouldn't do during Hungry Ghost Festival. So that includes in going home late and staying out late and then go to dark areas, somehow wearing cheongsam in the middle of the freaking night.
After that, when we were supposed to give the umbrellas to the cheongsam girls, right? Which is actually also a very taboo thing to do in 7 months and under shelter. I only got to know of this superstition from the Cheongsam girls.
Hungry Ghost Festival, this kind of thing don't play.
The biggest challenge was actually to execute that vision with the limited resources that we have. And I think actually at the end of the day, we managed to pull it off, which is quite commendable.
Lastly, I would like to thank everybody who has been involved in this project. The producers, to production, to post-production, people who are involved in the visual effects. So after listening to all the crap that we have said, right, Zayden's music video will also be released at the same day, at the same time as this video. So if you want to watch his video after listening to what we have said and interested to know what is the end product like, please click on the link below.